Okay, I'd like to do another example of solving the bipartite matching problem. And we'll be using the Ford Fulkerson algorithm to compute maximum flow in a network to do that. So here is my bipartite graph, cleverly drawn to show you the two subsets of vertices that give the partition. This is the X subset, the Y subset that gives you the partition of the original graph, which is G. That gives us the bipartite graph. Okay, so the first step of the solution is to, from G, compute a new graph, G prime. And the way we compute the G prime is that we make all our edges directional. We create a new S, which has an edge from it to every node in the X set, and a new node T, which has a edge from every node in the Y set to it. And then the capacities on all of these edges is 1. All right, now the next step is to solve the maximum flow on this G prime right here. And then from that, I go back and get the bipartite matching. Okay, so let's start. Well, this is the same as our GR, our residual graph. It is exactly the same as what I'm showing right here. So from the residual graph, I can find a path from S to T, and let's take S A X T. Okay, so from this path, I need to find the bottleneck. So it's, let's see, the minimum of 1, 1, and 1. So that bottleneck will give us 1. So then what I need to do, the next step, is to go back to the original graph GR, which is right here, and add the bottleneck to all of the flows on the corresponding edges. So here's SA. So I add 0 plus 1 gives me 1. AX, 0 plus 1 gives me, 0 plus 1 gives me 1. And XT right here, 0 plus 1 gives me 1 for that. Okay, so now here is my new G prime graph right here. And so I want to draw my residual graph based on that. So let me put my nodes first. Okay, so I can undo from A to S. That is, I have nothing left to go back. S to A, I can't push anything forward, I can only undo. S to B, I can push forward 1. A to W, I can push forward 1. A to X, I can undo 1. B to X, I can push forward 1. B to Y, push forward 1. B to Z, push forward 1. W to T, I can push forward 1. X to T, I can undo 1. Y to T, push forward. Z to T, push forward. Okay, so here's my residual graph, and all of these edges have a 1 on them. So I need to find a path from S to T. So how about S, B, I can't choose X, but I could choose Y, and then T. And that gives us a bottleneck of, let's see, min of 1, 1, and 1, so that gives us a bottleneck of 1. Okay, so I need to go back to my original graph now and update all of my flows by adding 1 to everything that corresponds S, B, Y, T to those edges right there. So S to B, I have a flow of 1. B to Y, I have a flow of 1. And Y to T, I have a flow of 1. All right, so my new residual graph is, as I'm showing you right here, W, X, Y, Z, T. Okay, I can undo A to S, so there's a backwards edge right there. And then similarly, S to B, I can undo that backwards edge there. A to W, I can push forward with 1. W to T, I can push forward with 1. A to X, I can undo that. X to T, I can undo that. B to X, that's, I can undo. B to, whoops, that's a, excuse me. B to X, that's still a forward edge. So I could push forward one. B to Y, that's an undo. Oh, well, I've got an eraser here. How about that? There we go. B to Y, that's an undo. Y to T, that's an undo. B to Z, I can push forward. And Z to T, I can push forward. So this is my residual graph. And I can see right here, there's no way I can get a path from S to T because I only have in edges on the S. So this is my graph right here, my G, the maximum flow on G prime. So now what I need to do is take this graph and see what my bipartite matching solution is. So let's copy this graph right here on a new piece of paper and continue. Okay, here is my solution to the maximum flow problem on the modified bipartite graph. Let's write out our bipartite graph looking at this. A, B, W, X, Y, Z. And everywhere here that I have a zero flow, I do not copy that edge. If I have a one flow, I copy that edge. So A to X will have an edge. And let's see, B to X, that's a zero. B to Y, that's a one. And then B to Z, that's a zero. So here is my solution right here. This is my M. So to write that out, actually, M is a subset of E, so it's AX and BY. And obviously the cardinality of M equals 2, and we are done.